Today we're going to be talking about the arena because it's a mode that you really should be doing if you're experienced or if you're new, and that's because you get daily rewards and weekly rewards. Now I don't know how good the daily rewards are for an experienced player, but they're certainly good for a new player, and the weekly rewards, well that's how you get some valuable vision card leveling mats, and those are kind of hard to come by. So I wanted to make this video because the arena can be kind of a pain in the ass. You have to do 10 matches per day to get all the daily rewards, and you get those rewards whether you win or lose, but it can be very intimidating for a new player, especially if you're losing or you don't know what you're doing yet. So we're going to go over some tips and tricks to maximizing your arena experience and getting it done quickly and painlessly. Let's start by taking a look at the arena menu. So we can see there's a bunch of stuff going on here. If we click on the banner, you're going to get a list of all the bonus units and some of the rules and stuff for the arena. So depending on the week, there's going to be different things that are forbidden, so skills that you can use and units and all sorts of things. There's also a medal exchange, but we'll talk about that after. And then you can see the ranking with yourself, your friends, and all this types of stuff. Now you can see I've got my 10 orbs here, and if I click here, I can see the participation rewards, and you get these if you win or lose, so they're really great. The Star Quartz, very important early on, less important later on, but all these pots are very valuable. Lapis is always good. And then some trust coins, I mean, it adds up after a while, so I think you definitely want to do all 10 if you can. Now, if you rank in a certain level here, well, you're going to be able to get a bunch of rewards as well. So even like looking at this ranking here, 3,000 to 30,000, this is where I ranked in, and I'm brand new. I just started, right? So how am I ranking so high? Well, it's not really that hard, but you get a bunch of really good rewards. The pots, again, are good. The metal Gigantar is here. That is massive. That's a vision card leveling material, and those are hard to get. So you definitely want to be getting these every single week. And then the Super TMR, these tickets, they're really good as well. So even if you don't rank that high, you still get a bunch of good stuff, and then you get one of these metal Gigantars. But you definitely don't want to be ranked up in this area where you don't get anything. But the Trust Moogles, like everything, these are good rewards. So you really do want to be doing this. And I know that you can be tempted not to. Okay, so we've looked at the rewards and the rules, but let's take a look at team composition. So you can see my team at the top here. It's separate from your usual team building, so you'll have to put it together. And I don't update this that often because it's separate from the main party thing, but you can use optimize if you want things not optimized. And that's kind of just what I've done. But you can see my whole team here. Now Strago's really interesting. I mean, he's got some magic skills. He's got some status effect stuff with bad breath. What's really cool is his limit break is able to instant KO everybody, has a chance of doing that at least. So if there's a really tricky unit, then you can use his limit break to try to get rid of that unit. And he was a free unit, so he's really solid for a free unit in arena. And if you play during Kingdom Hearts, then you might have the young Xehanort as well, and he's got an ability that can stop units, and that's also can be quite useful as well. So there's definitely the big thing though is that you want AoE attacks, and I'm going to show you why. That's the most important thing, is that you have, you know, five units that can use AoE attacks. Because we're going to pick on some weaker teams, and we want to get out of this mode as quickly as possible because the fights could drag on if we pick the wrong people. So let's take a look at picking opponents next. So you can also see that I've got Eldrin, who has a 100% bonus to the score that I get every time I complete a match, and so does Alina, but you only get the highest boost that you have. So Eldrin's going to give me the 100% boost, and then I'm good to go. And that actually means I rank up more easily, but that also means I can be put into a higher rank where I'm facing tougher opponents. But when you start out, you are going to have the easiest time, and you're going to have this list of opponents here, and it looks pretty scary. Like this guy is ranked 210, and I'm ranked 76. But we can keep scrolling down, and you're going to find teams. Like for example, there's this guy that's rank 81. Okay, so that's way closer to me, and I believe up here we had a guy that was ranked 85. So again, way closer to me. So you can pick people that are low rank, and when you start out, you're not going to see this screen. You're going to see people that are ranked like 20, people that are ranked 10, 5, whatever it is, and those are the people that you want to pick on. You're going to fight them repeatedly because you can just fight the same person. This list updates, I want to say it updates automatically every like 15 15 minutes or something. So you can just, if you can get all your matches done within those like 10 minutes or something, then you could fight the same guy that has like the beginner, Lastwell, and Rain set. You can fight them 10 times and be done, and that's it. And that's where the AoE attacks come in, because we want to actually use just spam 5 AoE attacks and hopefully kill the other team one hit, and then just go on to the next match, and so on. So let's see. We'll see if this guy is an easy target, because that will be good for demonstrating for the sake of this video. So at the beginning of every round, there's a little spinning thing, and it determines who's going to go first. And hopefully it's you, because that can give you a shot at taking out anybody. And we can see my opponent's got some older units, and then has some Neo Vision units as well. But I'm going first, and what I'm going to do is I'm just going to use, and it's really simple for me here. I'm just going to use my AoE attacks, and that's all. I'm going to queue them up as much as I can. I'm not even going to use my Brave Shifts, and the reason why is that I want to be able to use this repeat and reload feature so that every match can be super quick and simple. So there I have it, and if I was against a tough opponent, you know, maybe I have to think more about how I play, but we're trying to avoid people like that, so I'm just gonna spam it all, and we're gonna see, hopefully we can kill this team in one go. And if we can, well, look at that. So all they have left is the Starlight Elena, and you see this ability that Starlight Elena has. I have the same ability on my Elena, and I also have an ability on my Eldrin that will counter, and sometimes your opponent goes first and you just counter and kill them anyway. My opponent's a little bit tougher than I would normally fight against, but we'll see here. Eldrin's going to counter with the Siphon Flick, and there's the Refraction. So she's gonna go first, and then I'll get another chance to counter here, and then if Strigo doesn't die, we'll look at his LB, but it looks like he might. Didn't quite die there. And look, you can see how much that counter did. So I'll give you an example here. Let's see if Strigo's ability, if his LB can one-shot. No, it didn't. Okay, well anyway, so we'll go through and we'll use our abilities. And then that's it, we won. So even if we lost, we would still get this reward. You'll see here. And you can see I've got a 31 win streak. I have not lost yet this week, because I just pick opponents that I can beat, and literally anybody can do it. I started weeks ago, so it's definitely not a tough thing to be doing. You don't need to be wasting your time fighting tough opponents or anything like that. All right, I got some new opponents, so we're gonna take off on this new guy. And then hopefully this will be a match that we can one-shot. Now I do recognize that I'm lucky. Look, I've got all these Neo Vision units, and I've been very lucky on this account. But again, if you're not ranking up super fast, and I can just hit reload, look at that. I've got all my abilities again. We'll just go Aqua Breath with Strigo. Even if you're not as lucky as I am, you know, as long as you got units with AoEs and you're picking on weak teams, well, look at that. I just beat another opponent, and then I'm good to go. I can go queue up again. So another thing I can talk about is, you know, taking on some tougher opponents, because sometimes maybe you just get a bad list and you don't want to come back later when it refreshes, and you just want to fight the people here. And you know, this list I have right now isn't the best example, because I'm a little bit higher up, but you can see all these people that are really high ranks, and that doesn't necessarily mean that you can't beat them even if you're new, because they might have outdated units, they might be older accounts that are just high rank, but you know, they have non-Neo Vision units. And there's also the AI to take into account for PvP as well. So your opponent isn't fighting at full strength. There's kind of like a dice roll to see what type of AI they're gonna use. Sometimes they're gonna use limit breaks, or they're gonna use their best attacks. Other times they're gonna heal and buff and auto attack you. So you can beat anybody in that way, and you can definitely beat anybody if you go first. So there's definitely ways to beat people that are higher rank, and I've definitely beaten people that are, you know, rank 200 or higher, and that doesn't mean that I'm good, it just means that that's the way that PvP works. So let's fight another opponent that's, even though I found an opponent that I could exploit, let's fight another opponent and see how that goes, and if I can beat them. So luckily I went first, and I know everything is set up. I can just hit repeat, and my entire loadout is just gonna happen, and boom. So one thing I'll say is don't use the auto button. You might think, okay, well, I can just auto AFK these. If you're auto attacking your regular attack, if your opponent is also, you know, auto attacking with their regular attack, your matches could take forever. You really want to win or lose as quickly as possible. So if you are not interested in winning, then you could take on the toughest opponent you can find and hope they one-shot your party. But I do think that, you know, anybody can go on a win streak like this. You know, if I can do it, then I think anyone can do it. Alright, so we're all done for the day. I did my 10 matches and I actually ended up getting a refresh where there was a rank 28 player and I just played against them the rest of the matches and it was super easy. So to recap kind of the advice here, it's that, you know, pick some units with AoE attacks. If they have counters, that's good. If they have instant KOs or status effects that could be useful, again, that's great. Now, for your opponents, you're going to want to take on the lowest rank or the weakest looking opponent. You can take a look at, even if they're high rank, which units they have as their display unit. If it's an old unit, and you'll get to know as the game goes on, the more you play, which units are kind of outdated. You can definitely see if they're NeoVision or not. Then you can pick on those players as well if you don't really have a choice in your opponent. And you'll be able to win, you know, close to 100% of your matches because at the end of the day, the arena AI is not that good. And you're playing with the full capabilities that you have. But you want to make it as simple as possible. You want to have a nice AoE spread that you can just use on repeat, and you can get through the whole thing super quickly without, you know, wasting any of your day. And then at the very end, you're going to be able to go to the Metal Exchange. And you can see there's this big board, and when you complete it all, you will get this pot in the middle. It's a different pot each time. And you can just click on a square, and you can exchange your medals for that item. And these items are all really, really good for new players, and I think the pots and stuff and some of the mega sets that could be good for experienced players as well. And you can also just use this batch exchange, and look at that, now we've got a bunch of stuff unlocked. And as soon as you unlock this map or you finish this map, you'll just get another one, and then another one, and another one. So if you wanted to, these orbs, they're gonna recharge over time. You could just keep on doing arena to max out the map repeatedly. I don't know that that is worth it. After the first 10, you stop getting those participation rewards. You'll just get medals after that, but that's definitely something you don't want to forget about. But at the end of the day, who am I? I just started playing this game, and there's a ton of experienced players out there on Reddit and other websites, and there's also a lot of experienced players that are watching these videos, so go read the comment section, because I'm sure that there's going to be some great advice posted as well, if not some corrections for some things that I don't know that much about yet. But this is definitely something that you want to be doing every single day. Get your 10 matches in every single day, and for that matter, get your 7 spins in every single day, because you can get some energy pots, which when you start out, they're hard to come by, and you can get some lapis as well, so make sure you're doing those. It's definitely something that you need to get in the routine of doing your arenas, you know, your item worlds. And then one final thing is buying this bundle every day. I know this is not even the point of the video, but there's this bundle of enhancement, and you can buy one every single day that gives you a maxed King Minotaur, and that's a really powerful level up item. So you definitely want to buy this every single day without fail in order to max up your level up your units even faster. Alright, that's going to be it for this video, and I'm sure that we'll connect in the comments, so thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.